guys, welcome back to the channel. Theo here. On today's video, I'm going to tell you about the 5 things I love about my 981 Cayman S right there. So, let's go! Long-time subscriber of the channel, you will know that I purchased this car around March. So I feel like now that it's been 10 months, I have enough, you know, seat time on the car, and I can provide you my review and also provide you actually about the things that I actually love with this car. Yes, I purchased this car, and after driving and owning it for that long, there are things that I just cannot get enough on the car, and this is exactly what I'm going to talk to you about today. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and talk about the number one. The number one thing that I love about this car is simply the look. This car is beautiful, and I love the way that Porsche designed their cars. I mean, not just me, a lot of people, everyone, any enthusiast, you know, dream to have a Porsche. And this is kind of like one of the ultimate handling car. So this Cayman here is the version that has the mid-size engine. You know, Porsche has the 911, they have trucks, but this is the only Porsche that has the mid-size engine. Now, I'm going to talk about that mid-size engine in a few moments when I'm talking about other items that I like about this car. But for now, we are only talking about the looks. So this looks just like a Porsche. Yes, it is a Porsche. So the traditional look that you can find on the 911 is also what you have here, where you have these curves, these lines, slopy roof lines. And this specific one has the GT4 wing. Yes, it's a cheater because it's not actually a GT4, but it's kind of have that wing to give that look, and I love it. I definitely love it. I mean, look at it. Every single angle that you look at this car, you can just see the beauty. Man, this car is definitely a head turner. When I walk around, you can see every single angle the car looks beautiful. I mean, from the top, it looks good. From the back here, it looks good. From the side, it looks good. I mean, every angle, this car looks beautiful. Look at it. You tell me on the comment below if you don't think that this car looks beautiful. Yes, it is dirty, so forgive me, but it's super cold right now, so washing the car is a little challenging. And I have been driving this car for the past 2 weeks, every single day, going to places, to work, and yeah, that's why the car is filthy like that. First item that I love about this car is simply the look. It looks like a supercar without actually being a supercar. You know, it gives you that look, and then whenever you park it, you have to look back. You always look back. I always look back. Whenever I drive this, whenever I park it, man, ooh. Man, this car is just simply a beauty. After the look, the second thing that I want to mention about this car is simply, you know, the power delivery, handling, all of that. You know, I want to kind of put all of that into one specific category because I feel like this car, you know, I can address it this way. Now, this car makes 325 horsepower, but trust me, whenever you drive it, you will feel like it has 400 horsepower just because the way Porsche found to deliver the power. And then the fact that, you know, this car handles, being a mid-size engine, you can take corner at a higher speed, you feel like the car is faster than it actually is. This car only has 325 horsepower, but it handles better than my F80 M3 that had about over 450 horsepower. Yes, this car is capable of doing that. And the mid-size meaning the engine is literally back here, although I have tents, you won't be able to see. It's like sitting right behind there. It's not actually on the back, like the 911 is actually mid-size. So meaning if I open this, oh, it is locked, you will see. Actually, let me go on the other side and show you where that engine sit. Do not know. So when you open like that and I recline the seat, this is literally the engine right here, right behind me. So when I'm driving, it's right behind me, just like a Porsche should be. So second thing I love about the car is simply the way the power is being delivered. I have an E46 M3, which is also a natural aspirated six-cylinder engine. This one is also six-cylinder, but the way BMW and Porsche are doing the delivery of the power is night and day in comparison. This one is more like, you know, you going to the opera and listen to a fine-tuned music that is not going to destroy your eardrums. And the E46 M3 is like you listening to hip-hop and you have that 808 bass and it's banging. You know, to each their own. I love both cars. Don't get me wrong. I'm not trying to downplay the E46, but the E46 just delivered the power a little raw. While this one, it's like it's fine-tuned. It's like the power delivery is progressive. You can predict what the car is going to do whenever you press the gas at a specific, you know, RPM. It's just like that. I don't know how I can explain it. You just have to feel it. Compared to the E46 M3, where sometimes, you know, it's like it's going to kill you, honestly. But it's also fun to drive that car. So the second thing is just the power delivery handling of this car. And let me tell you, this car is not even the highest version. You have the GT4 that has the GT3 suspension. The engine is completely tuned differently. That handled even better than this. So this one I feel like already handled more than my F80 M3, but the GT4 takes the handling to another level. The third thing that I love about this car is simply the fact that it's a manual. This car comes with a PDK and it also comes with a manual transmission, as you can see right here. It's 6-speed. And man, when I tell you, man, this is the best manual transmission I've ever driven. I don't think that, you know, I can drive any other car manual after feeling this. Because now when I drive any other manual, I feel like I'm missing out. I feel like, oh man, why am I even killing myself doing this? This is perfect. I mean, the way the gears are just, you know, first of all, there is no play. Look at that. There is no play. It's crisp. When you go to first, you can hardly miss. You cannot miss gears. It's just that good. I don't know how to do it, but BMW definitely need to step their game up in terms of the manual transmission. They are not the worst, but this is night and day. I mean, after driving this, you don't want to go back. It's like you woke up out of darkness and suddenly you found light. You will never want to go back to the darkness. This is just that good. I mean, whenever I'm driving and I'm shifting gears, oh, you can easily, oh man, I don't even know. Look at that. And you can feel every single shift. Now, I've added the short shifter kit here to make it look like the GT4. And since then, it took it even to another level. So I didn't even know that, you know, the shifting could be better after I purchased the car. But once I installed the short shifter kit, man, it took it to another level. And this is, man, I don't know, man. You just have to feel it. I mean, if you go to a dealership someday, just sit down to one of the manual car and do this. Trust me, just do this. If you drive a manual car, you would not want to drive your manual car again after feeling this. That's just how good this is. And this is why I did not choose the PDK, because I wanted to experience this. A lot of people mentioned that this was good. When I test drove this car, I just said, hey man, I have to have this manual gear. Now the PDK is also good. A lot of people mentioned in reviews that the PDK is one of the best transmission out there. I've never, you know, test driven the PDK, so I cannot provide any feedback. But based on what other people report, PDK on the Porsche, which is the automatic version of this car, it's also excellent. So best of both worlds. Another item that I love about this car, man, you already know. When I come to the back of the car and I go down low like this, you already know. It is the exhaust. This car, when I purchased it, had the PSE exhaust, which is the sport, you know, the Porsche sport exhaust. It is great, don't get me wrong, but for me, coming from an F80, coming from an F36 M3, coming from a Mini Cooper that my neighbors hated because it was super loud, I needed, you know, that thing to be loud. I mean, that's it. The sound is beautiful, but since I installed the Soul Performance exhaust, I felt like the exhaust just woke up. And I love the way that Porsche is doing the exhaust. So even when I'm driving with the flap open and then you drive it at low speed, the car is still not super loud. But once you hit that 4,000 RPM, oh yes, that engine is waking up, and that's when you can hear the roar that everyone talks about. Porsches, man, just drive this thing above 4,000 RPM, you can hear it, man. That engine, since it's sitting behind my ears, it is loud and ringing, and it's beautiful. I love the way it just sounds. When you shift gears and it downshift, that automatic downshift, or if you're doing the downshift yourself, oh my goodness, it is pure car porn. I swear to God, this is why I'm addicted to driving this car. Every single time I get a chance to drive this car, I drive it. And I drive it in sport mode, exhaust all out, and yeah, even in a cold like this, without winter tires, yes, it's a risk, I'm still pushing it like that. I love this. The sound is just beautiful. I mean, I'm gonna make you listen to the sound right now, but the car is cold. That's why I don't want to rev it. I'm gonna put a clip about, you know, how this sound whenever I'm driving. Yeah. other item that I love about this car is simply the storage. This car, for its size, has a lot of storage. Meaning, I repeat, for its size. Don't go comparing this Cayman to an SUV because they cannot compare. But for a two-seater, this has a lot of space. Remember, this car doesn't have any back seats. It's only two-seater. That's why I'm comparing this for like Corvettes or other cars that fit into this category. If you have any of those, you will know what I'm talking about. This has a lot of space. On the front here, you can easily put two suitcases, one on top of each other. Right now, I have the, you know, indoor cover right here. I have my jacket, and you can put another suitcase on top, put a bunch of stuff on the side here, and that will be only here for the top. Now, on the back here, you have an extra space because the engine is mid-size. As I mentioned earlier, this is the engine under there. Right here, you can put another bag, just like that bag that I had on the front there. You can put it right here. Usually, when I go do groceries, I put them right here because I'm still used to putting stuff on the back. So I use this to put groceries. Now you can also put item here on the top, you know, and even here inside these holes you have other storage. Now mind you, on the door you also have storage right here, but you can't really put a lot of things. You have storage right here, you have storage right here. Now if you have small things, you can also fit them behind your seat. So this car has a lot of storage for its size. That's one thing I like about this car, is that if you're going for a weekend, you know, you can take this car and rock it and it's going to be great. So you will have practicality of having, you know, the space to put all your things, and you know, the looks, the handling, the exhaust sound, and yeah, best of every world. Another thing I like about this car is just the technology in it. Now this car, remember, it's a 2014, but for the year it has great technology. First, it has, you know, the start and stop feature, meaning that whenever I'm driving in regular mode and I come to a stop, the engine is going to shut down to kind of save on gas. You know, this car has navigation, it has Bluetooth, it has a bunch of other things. For example, it has sensors that's going to tell you about, you know, your car pressure. You can even have the navigation here on the top, just like any modern cars. These are things that, you know, back in 2014 you didn't really see in cars. Most of the time navigation were like on this display, but this one, no, it's there. I've never really used this because I always use the map directly from my phone, and I don't have Apple CarPlay, unfortunately, with this car. You know, this car has parking sensors on the front, on the back. Well, one thing it doesn't have is backup camera. So if you're looking for backup camera here, this car doesn't have it, but it has the parking sensor that can help you to park. And you know, it just has a lot of things that will help you in terms of technology. You know, things like, you know, calculating your, you know, tire pressure, calculating your, you know, gas mileage and things like that. It has a lot of technology, a lot of features and things that, you know, for a car of this age, it is really, really great. You see here, for example, it has the gear shift assist, meaning that whenever, you know, I'm driving in manual gear, if I have this window right there, it's going to tell me when it's time to shift. Let's say if I forget to shift or something, but I never really drive with this window right here. But let's say that if you're novice, you can use this to know exactly what would be the perfect time to shift, because it's going to tell you the time to shift, and you can shift and actually have good gas mileage, which actually this car, you know, does. I just don't have any trip recorded here, but I've averaged usually around 26, 27 miles to the gallon. That's mixing city and highway driving when I go to work usually. And for a car, for a sports car, especially me driving in sport and, you know, always being in high RPM, is actually doing good on gas. It is much better than my F80, and I just love it. There you have it. Now you know all the things that I love about my specific 981 Cayman right there. And this car, one thing I also want to add is that this car is very, very reliable. I've talked on the forum to a lot of people that own, you know, 981 Caymans, and they all mentioned that the car is reliable. For people that have owned it for like 4 years, they mentioned that this car is reliable. Since I owned this car, I only had one single issue. And then that issue only became because I changed the exhaust, and it was a vacuum valve that wasn't installed properly, and that's what was giving me an error code, and I just had to replace the cable. And once I did that, the car was fine. If I did not install the Soul Performance exhaust, I would not have that issue because that cable would not be unplugged. So it was more like my issue, me creating the issue, compared to the car breaking down on its own. This is a beautiful car, and For a car that costs less than 60 grand, you can easily have a good time, have fun, take it to the track and enjoy it. So on this note, I hope that you like the video. See you on the next video. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, make sure that you do, and talk to you guys later. Bye bye.